On behalf of Gary and the rest of the family, we want to welcome you to the memorial service for our beloved Ramona. Would y'all please join me as we ask the Lord to join us in this celebration. Wonderful, gracious Heavenly Father, we are here today to thank you. To thank you for the life that you gave Ramona. What a wonderful, wonderful life you gave her. It is with sadness that we have to say goodbye. Not goodbye, see you later. Father, we thank you for the life that she lived. We thank you that she called your son a savior. And for that, we give you celebration. We ask you to be with us by your Holy Spirit in this service. We'll be sure to praise the name of your son, as Ramona is right now. We ask this in his name. Amen.
Hello, My name is Madeline. I'll be reading the obituary today. First of all, I would like to thank all of you for joining us today to celebrate the life of my grandmother. It warms my heart to know that she was loved by so many. Ramona Neal Peacock entered her heavenly home on March 8, 2022 in Nacogdoches, Texas, at the age of 83. She was born on April 3, 1938 in Bastrop, Louisiana, to Quincy and Lily Neal. Ramona grew up in Bastrop, where she went to school all the way up until her high school graduation. She then moved on to college, attending Louisiana Tech University, where she earned a bachelor's and master's degree in math education. Ramona taught for over 40 years before retiring. She started her career in West Monroe, Louisiana, but over the years taught in Waco, Texas, Shamrock, Texas, Borger, Texas, Mojave, California, and Portland, Texas. Many of these moves were following her husband, Gary, as teaching was a passion they shared and were both following their dreams of continuing their education and teaching others. Ramona met Gary while she was teaching in West Monroe and was out with one of his friends. 1 week later, while Gary was working as a professor, she happened upon his office when she was coming to use the library, but really was coming to see him. After that day, they went out every single night for 6 months until they were joined in matrimony on April 12, 1968. Together, they shared 53 years of life, love, and adventure, and raised two children who in turn blessed them with many grandchildren to dote upon. Family was one of the utmost importance to Ramona, and she made sure to never miss a moment of her children and grandchildren's lives. She would tenderly scratch their back, make fantastic milkshakes, and take them to all sorts of summer camps held at Stephen F. Austin State University. Her family holds on to fond memories of Mimi, traveling to be at the birth of each grandchild, folding newspapers for the church, and visiting during the summer. Ramona was a member of the First Christian Church of Nacogdoches for over 20 years and spent many of those years working as a deaconess. She was an avid reader, having many books spread throughout the house as well as crossword puzzle books, which she did until her final days here on earth. Ramona spent many hours in her garden with Gary and volunteering together at the SFA Mast Arboretum. She was a loving and gentle woman who will be dearly missed by all who had the pleasure of knowing her. Ramona is survived by her beloved husband, Ronald Gary Peacock, daughter Michelle Owens and husband Mike, son Michael Peacock and wife Dawn, brother Alan Neal and wife Judy, and grandchildren Megan Peacock Alston and husband Tanner. Tanner Seymour, Madeline Seymour, Riley Peacock, Evan Peacock, Leslie Owens, and Amanda Owens. Ramona is preceded in death by her parents, Quincy and Lily Neal. Now I would like to take the time to read some of my own words. Ramona Peacock, or better known to me and the rest of her grandchildren as Mimi, was a beautifully strong-minded, brilliant, and loving woman. I remember laying in bed only but 4 or 5 years old, crying my eyes out because I realized that one day I would unfortunately lose the woman that brought love everywhere she went. I will never forget the time spent alone with her as she taught me to read, scratched my back, and even happily ate the nastiest concoctions I would whip up while playing restaurant with Beanie Babies covering her head to toe. She would always give me 5 stars. I looked up to her for many reasons, one of which was the way she could admit when she was scared about other people's judgment, but would never let that stand in the way of doing what she wanted and believed was right. She never let the odds defy her. She knew what she wanted and would go for it. She started the family I have today, and I will forever be grateful for them and for her. Losing Mimi is a tremendous loss, but a tremendous gain for heaven. Thank you. Now I would like to invite my sister Megan up.
Hello, my name is Megan Peacock Alston, and I wanted to read my Mimi's favorite Bible verse today. For everything there is a season and a time for every matter under heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up what is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. Ecclesiastes 3, verse 1 through 4. I had a few words I wanted to say, but I think I'm just going to kind of speak from the heart. My Mimi was an amazing person. She was my grandmother, but she also helped raise me to be who I am today. And she gave up her retired golden years to raise a kid all over again. And I couldn't be more thankful for that. I asked her what her favorite color was, and I thought this was funny. She said, green or blue, it really depends on my mood. And honestly, I can relate to that. She loved cats, and she loved flowers so much. She loved working in the garden with my dad. I would always find them out there working. And she loved rock hunting. They have a whole big collection of rocks. It's amazing, and they're beautiful. She used to love going to the national forests and reading and spending time with her family. I just know she's going to be truly missed, because I know I do. Thank you, guys.
We often fall.
Gary and Ramona and myself shared two incredible things in common. Back in the late 80s and early 90s, we lived within blocks of each other in Portland, Texas. I had no idea. And in 2002, we both joined First Christian Church at the same time. Pretty amazing. Megan was part of my first class at First Christian Church. I'm really surprised they stayed, honestly. But it was such a joy to have that family in our church. Such a joy to see how wonderful they worked and served the Lord Jesus Christ at First Christian Church. Recently, within the past month, I had the honor of performing Megan and Tanner's wedding together. They originally had scheduled to get married in October, but with Ramona's declining health, they loved her and wanted her to be a part of their union. What an amazing gift. Thank you, Megan and Tanner. Family and friends, we're gathered here this afternoon with our hearts full of sadness, and we're mourning the loss of a dear loved one. For those of you that loved Ramona, you'll have a hole in your heart that'll hurt for a long time. Ramona was a very special soul. She was quiet, but yet strong. She was introspective and a deep thinker. For that, she garnered my respect, and I'm sure all of y'all's. If you could ever define the term meekness in a human being, Ramona would have been the one. She was assured of herself, but she walked quietly. I think the best thing about Ramona was her smile. She was genuinely a warm soul. And I'll tell you what, the best way you could get her to smile was to talk about her grandkids. They were the love of our life, and she loved each one of you individually, and it showed. She was the picture of a perfect grandmother. Ramona loved all of y'all with a love that's hard to define. Truly, that is a love that her Creator gave her, and it was enormous. Her daughter, Michelle, as we were just talking before Ramona passed, she showed me a picture of Ramona in her 20s. And I'm telling you, she was a model gorgeous. Gary, you hit the lottery. But in the last few months of her life, the disease that she had slowly dwindled her outside beauty. But you could never take the beauty that Ramona had away. You see, Ramona was beautiful from the inside out. And that's kind of spectacular. For those of us that love Ramona, time is going to have to pass by before the healing begins. And it's okay, because when we lose somebody so special, it hurts. And when we feel that loss, the most wonderful thing about time is it does take the pain away, and it leaves us with sweet memories. Sweet memories of the wonderful times that y'all had with your mother and grandmother. Those are precious. Treasure them the rest of your life. what it would be like to sit down with those that have gone before us that we loved, just to sit and talk. Talk about the joys of our lives, the hurts and the memories. That'll have to wait until you see her in glory. The sadness that we feel is because we're selfish. We don't want to leave somebody that we love so much. We always want those that we love to be near us. But we have to let them go. When you think about her now, where she is now, there's no sadness. There's no joy. There's no pain. There's no sorrow. She is in the presence of her Savior. A long time ago, she put her trust in her beautiful nail-scarred hands of her Savior. She believed that Christ paid for her sins on the cross because of the perfect love that he had for her. She believed that she would spend eternity in heaven with him. First Thessalonians 4:13 reads, "But we do not want you to be uninformed, brothers, about those who are asleep, that you may not grieve as others who do have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep." Ramona's hope was in Christ's resurrection. The day before Ramona went to the hospital and subsequently Stallings Court, I had the pleasure of visiting Gary and Ramona in their house. She was showing me the pictures of her grandkids and how she treasured all of them. I had a moment to talk to her about Jesus, her Savior. She said something to me that I rarely get. I've walked many people to heaven's throne. Most of the time they're scared. Most of the time they're worried. But not Ramona. She said she was ready to go home. God had given her a full life. And I want to tell you something else extraordinary. The cancer that Ramona had should have been full of pain. Ramona didn't have any pain up until the very last. What a gift that her Savior gave her. What a gift. I want to read another scripture that kind of fits Ramona's mindset of being ready to go see her Savior. The Apostle Paul writes in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 6 through 8. And I can see Ramona saying this. "For I am already being poured out as a drink offering, and the time of my departure has come. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award me on that day. And not only me, but also to all who have loved his appearing." You see, when Ramona entered into eternity, the moment after she exhaled her last breath, she stood on a foundation that was based in Christ Jesus. And that foundation can never be shook, because he is the one who defeated death. He defeated sin. And Ramona trusted him in that. And she too is celebrating that victory. You know, in Revelation, the last, I think Revelation 20, it says that he will wipe away every tear from their eye. I don't know whether I believe that or not. I may get in trouble from my Bible scholars. I think he will wipe away every sad and broken tear, certainly. But some of my most amazing, joy-filled times in my life, there's been tears. Lots of tears. But those aren't tears of sadness. Those are tears of joy. And I can't think but as she embraced her Savior and knowing the perfect love that he had for her, that the tears were flowing. But the sobs that she had were not sobs of pain or fear, but sobs of joy. No more crippled body. The arm that was wounded from the time she was born was made strong. And she hugged her Savior, the one in whom she hoped her whole life, for the first time. She was praising her King and her Lord. Our tears today aren't the same. They are filled with sadness at her loss. We'll miss Ramona's warm smile and her care. So in the midst of our tears and sadness, I pray that along with those tears, there may be some joyful tears, thanking God for rescuing Ramona. Because you know what? She's more alive today than she's ever been. But now our walk with y'all is over. But the direction she walked with y'all is still there. And it leads straight to the loving arms of her Savior. Death is an eye-opening occurrence. Usually it opens us up to our own mortality. How am I living my life? What's the purpose of my life? Do I need to make changes to the direction I'm going? I believe your instruction is to follow the same path Ramona was on. And if you do follow the Savior, maybe while you're on that path, somebody will follow you as others followed her. My question to you today is this, and I believe Ramona would ask you the same question. Have you made Jesus your foundation? Have you asked him to save you from your own sin and brokenness? Because he's the only one who can. Maybe today's the day to get that right. If you have made him your Savior, and if you know the love of Christ, praise his holy name and thank him for the hope that you have beyond this life. If you have, you're on the straight path that Ramona showed us. Would y'all join me in prayer? Wonderful, gracious God, it is truly a joy to celebrate a beautiful life that you've given. Father, you created Ramona in your image. No other before her, no other after her will contain the gifts that you gave her. Your creative hand is so beautiful. Father, we mourn today her loss. The soul that you gave her is with you. And there will be a vacancy in her family's hearts and her friends' hearts for a long time. Thank you for the memories that you allowed this family to share, the great love that Ramona gave them will live on in their hearts, and I thank you for that. Father, comfort this family with your love, your mercy, and your grace, having the compassion of our Savior. May he ever be with them. We praise you again for the life that you gave, and we praise you even more for the life that is with you, praising your name. We'll be sure to praise you too in this time. I pray this in the name of the one who is above all names, your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Satisfied.